Let us discuss about semiconductor strain gauge, or we can call it as piezoresistive strain gauge. Here, what is the use of these gauges means? They will find the applied pressure or applied force on a given structure, or sometimes we can use for finding the vibrations of a given structure. Here, it will find very accurate value of applied force or applied pressure in small amount. Okay, let us take this is a taken structure. The applied force, if it is very small, it is finding very accurate value. Why it is finding very accurately for small forces only means the whatever material we are using in these strain gauges, that material is brittle. So brittle material will give the values only for of small amount. Why it is calling two names means in this first type we are using semiconductor material in the strain gauge for finding the forces. In next one we are using piezoelectric crystals for finding the strain in a gauge. Okay, and we can call these gauges are bonded type strain gauge. Why these are bonded type means whatever structure we are taking, okay, so on this surface of the structure we are pasting this strain gauge. Okay, we are pasting this strain gauge on the surface of the taken structure with the help of adhesive, okay, for finding the applied forces. That's why these are called bonded type strain gauge. The other two types are there, bonded type strain gauges. I will give the video link in description box, please check it. Let us take the basic principle of it. Here, as I told, whenever we are applying the forces on the given structure, okay, it is getting strain. It is getting strain means its dimensions of the structure are changing. Okay, because of change in dimensions of the structure, whatever strain gauge we are sticking here, pasting here, it is getting strain. It is changing in dimension. Okay, of this material, either semiconductor or piezoelectric crystals. So change in dimension will also change the resistance of that material. That resistance, change in resistance, will measure the strain of the structure or applied forces on it in the calibrated form. For this resistance, applied forces, it has some 10 newtons, 20 newtons, like that. This change in resistance of this material will find the applied force in the calibrated form. For 10 ohms, the applied force is 10 newtons, like that. Let us take the description of first semiconductor strain gauge. This is the semiconductor strain gauge. In it, there are three main parts. First part is semiconductor material. There are two types of semiconductor materials, N type and P type. N means negative semiconductor, P means positive semiconductor. So what is the meaning of semiconductor material means? According to conductivity, conductivity means which can pass the electricity through it. According to this conductivity, materials are three types: conductors, semiconductors, insulators. Okay, conductors have more conductivity, it is passing more electricity through it, and semiconductors have also some conductivity, it is the medium conductivity. This conductivity is less than the conductor material. Okay, and if you are taking insulators, they will not pass the electricity, no electricity is passing through it. It is called insulator. The meaning is semiconductors have conductivity which is in between conductors and insulators. Okay, this semiconductor material we are using in the first part in the description. Okay, this semiconductor material we are fixing here in the strain gauge. And here second part is this plate. This plate is, we can call it as backing plate. It may be plastic material or polyester or stainless steel backing. Okay, that steel plate or plastic plate we are taking of some thickness, little thickness. We are fixing this semiconductor material or pasting this semiconductor material for this stainless steel plate, okay, or backing plate. Okay, it is the second part. This plate is backing is second part. And third part is we are taking this semiconductor wires and we are fixing with the gold wires, gold leads, by soldering at two ends. Okay, why we are extending these wires means we are connecting these two leads to the Wheatstone bridge. Here Wheatstone bridge is the third part in it, in the description. So what Wheatstone bridge will measure means, Wheatstone bridge will measure the change in resistance in the semiconductor material. Okay, that Wheatstone bridge is the third part. Okay, there are three main parts. And then if we are using piezoresistive strain gauge, instead of the semiconductor, we are using piezoelectric material. Okay, here crystals we are taking, okay, in the wafer form. For the piezoelectric crystals or piezoresistive material, we are taking either silicon crystals or germanium crystals. These crystals we are calling the piezoelectric crystals. What we are doing with these crystals means, we are taking one rectangular form, okay, it is called wafer, okay, wafer of silicon or wafer of germanium. If you are taking wafer of silicon, on this thin plate, on this thin wafer, we are keeping these crystals, silicon crystals, okay, these are the silicon crystals I have written here. Okay. These crystals are bonding with the boron crystals. Okay, it is called doping process. Adding of boron and silicon crystals is called doping process. Or we can, these crystals we can call it as doped crystals. Okay, we can use silicon crystals or we can use the germanium crystals with boron crystals. Okay, so here we are taking this wafer. This wafer we are keeping here. Okay, in the description, the first material is piezoelectric material or wafer. Okay, rectangular. So this is the first part, and same second part is same as it is, plastic or polyester or stainless steel backing sheet, and we are sticking these crystals or wafer on this plate. And third part is Wheatstone bridge. We are taking these leads and it is connecting to the Wheatstone bridge. In it also, piezoelectric resistive strain gauge, there are three parts. Okay, let us take the working operation of this strain gauge. For finding the applied forces on a structure, first take this structure under study. Okay, so on it we are applying the forces at both sides. This some F amount of force we are applying at both sides. We need to find this force. For finding this force, we are sticking this strain gauge on the surface of the structure. Here we are connecting this strain gauge, okay, wires. What type of wires we are using? Golden leads or golden wires. We are connecting to the Wheatstone bridge. This Wheatstone bridge is outside this structure, okay, with the help of long wires. Okay, now apply the force at both sides of the structure. Because of application of force, the length of this structure is increasing. If you are applying the force, length of this is increasing, and width and thickness of the structure are getting reduced. Okay, and because of it, the entire structure is getting strain. Change in dimension is called strain. So it, the structure is getting strain. Because of it, the strain gauge is also will get the strain, means it is also changing its dimensions. Okay, because of it is getting strain, the resistance of this material, or we can call it as resistivity, it is also related to resistance. So this resistance of this material is changing. How can we find the change in resistance? Means here we are connecting the Wheatstone bridge. Wheatstone bridge will give the change in resistance of this material. Okay, let us see how the Wheatstone bridge is finding the resistance of it when it is getting strain. See the working operation of the Wheatstone bridge. Let us take the Wheatstone bridge, how it is working. First, it has four resistance, R1, R2, R3, R4. This bridge, this resistance are symmetrical about horizontal axis and vertical axis. Now for supplying the current to this bridge, we are taking the battery here. The amount of current we can control by using the rheostat. By changing the resistance, whatever current we want, we can supply to the bridge. Here, let us take at this after arrangement. Okay, so we know this R1 value, resistance R1, R2 value we know, R3 value we know, R4 we don't know. Let us assume like that. We have to find R4. Okay, we are supplying some current, so that in it some, it is showing some current, G value. G means galvanometer. It is showing some current, means this amount of current is passing in this circuit. Here what you do means adjust this current so that whatever current inside this galvanometer is zero. Keep this is zero by changing this rheostat. Okay, at that time I is zero is called null position. Okay, at that I0, we can call this bridge is in balanced condition. Balanced condition means the ratio of resistance this side is equal to ratio of this resistance this side. Means R1 by R4 is equal to R2 by R3. Ratio of these two resistance is equal to ratio of these two resistance. When it is possible, means when the galvanometer reading I is 0. Okay, by using this formula, we can find R4. R4 is equal to, this side R4 will go, R1 is as it is, into R3 by R2. So this is the main use of this Wheatstone bridge of finding the resistance. Okay, by using this resistance, change in resistance, we can find the change in dimensions of the structure also, and also we can find the applied forces in the calibrated form. So we can use for both purpose. This change in resistance will give the applied force value. How it is given, this resistance to the force value, means here we will have calibrated scale. For every gauge, one calibrated scale will be prepared. Let us assume the resistance, change in resistance of Wheatstone bridge is 10 ohms. By seeing these values, the applied force is 10 newtons here. Let us assume the Wheatstone bridge is giving the resistance value is 30 ohms. The applied force by seeing this calibrated scale is 30 newtons. Let us assume we are getting the Wheatstone bridge 25 newtons in between. Okay, 25 newtons means it is the mean of these two values. So the applied force is between these two. Okay, it is 25 newtons. Okay, like that we can find the applied force by using the calibrated scale. In this working operation, as I told, whenever we are applying force, resistance of this material is changing. Okay, if we are taking the semiconductor type here, this gauge. Okay, again in it we can use two types materials, as I told in description. Okay, negative type semiconductor or positive type semiconductor. If you are using this material is negative type semiconductor, in it the resistance, whatever resistance is developing, it is inversely proportional to the applied force. Okay, and in the positive type semiconductor, if you are using here, the change in resistance, whatever resistance is there, it is proportional to the applied force. Okay, remember these two for the different semiconductor material. So overall here resistance is changing. This resistance is giving the applied force in this structure. Applications of this gauge are, this can use for finding the small amount of force very accurately. And we can apply for the finding pressure in pressure cells. And we can use for finding the vibrations of motors or engines. Okay. So advantages of these gauges are, these are small in size, so lightweight, and accuracy is 2.3% of strain, and it is giving good response. Okay, very sensitive, and it has good fatigue life. And the limitations of these gauges are, these are measuring only small amount of forces. For the big amount of forces, these are not giving the correct value. And for every gauge, one gauge factor is there. Gauge factor is nothing but the ratio of resistance strain to the linear strain. Okay, R is resistance here, L is length. Okay, DL by L is called strain, linear strain, and this is the resistance strain. The ratio between these two is called gauge factor. For every gauge, one gauge factor is there. So in this gauges, this gauge factor is changing. Okay, with the change in the material, negative type semiconductor, positive type semiconductor, or piezo resistive material, and then it has no linearity, good linearity. So that is change in resistance will change the force, correct? But here according to this, in the n-type, R is inversely proportional to 1 by force. Here it is proportional to force. Okay, linearity is not good, and it is very sensitive to the temperature changes also. At a very high and very low temperature, it is giving the wrong value. And then these gauges are costly, and it is difficult to paste on the surface of the taken structure. Okay, these are the important points in today's class. Share this video with your friends. If you like this lecture, please subscribe my channel and press the bell icon for more updates. Thank you for watching.